the recording for this session of working on OMS Central. Right now, I'm just starting off with what I used to have, which is just a blank page from the Material UI premium themes. I'm comparing it with the existing OMS Central, and I want to make the course detail functionality come alive. So that's the primary thing. It looks like there's a bunch of functionality here, like filtering, sorting. I'm not too excited about this kind of filtering. I don't think that makes a lot of sense. I don't think people use it a lot. So those are more sort of design decisions that I'm going to take later on. So if I head back to the original page, all I have is data showing up on screen. But basically, I got to do some routing. I got to navigate the database that we see here. This is the Firebase dev version, just for testing. I need to go from the courses, where I have all this data. And then I need to go to reviews. And from the reviews, I need to pick out the reviews and display the content of the reviews. So that's the challenge. And let's have a look at the review data structure. It's just a bunch of flat JSON data with like course and ID and rating and semester. So we'll just have to go from courses and add in a bunch of stuff, add in routing. I'm going to use a reach router. All of that's going to need to be done by this recording. As I'm recording right now, I've already done it, but what you're seeing here is actually the video recording of my process of going through and coding it up from what I had, which was just getting stuff to show on screen with the raw Material UI starter. So here I think I'm going to start running yarn start, but I don't think I have anything else to say, so I'm just going to fast forward it and maybe do some commentary in the middle and at the end. Cheers.
Salsa, sombrero, gato, negro, mojito, old del paso, Madrid, Chihuahua, Adelé, por favor, bailando. Guacamole, jalapeño, salva Hayek, Ricky Martin, bacalao, muy bueno, mariachi, gasolina, calamari, muchas gracias, Macarena, mi amigo, leve la vida loca, Antorillo, Panteras. Machete enchilada, 1, 2, 3, 4, Tony Montana, guacamole, jalapeño, salva Hayek, Ricky Martin, bacalao, muy bueno, mariachi, gasolina, calamari, muchas gracias, Macarena, mi amigo, leve la vida loca, Antorillo, Panteras.
Okay, checking it at the 1 hour mark. This is, I got the course list working, and now I'm working on the course details page. Basically having to look at the data structure and seeing how to render that. I've mostly got it done. I just want to truncate the text here, but then also provide some way of expanding it so you don't have to click through to see the text since you already have it here. So we're gonna do a bit of use state in there. Yeah, the coding is going kind of slowly, but I think the first hour was taken up with trying to figure out what the best way of accessing the review data was. I also wasn't sure if the review data was even right because it was not matching up with the real site, the real OMS Central site. Then I figured out, oh, I was working on a dev database, not the production database, and that's why there is a difference. So then I stopped worrying about it. And I was also trying to think about performance. I was also trying to think about pagination, how I would want to do that. I basically ended up not doing it. I also struggled with isolated modules because I'm using Create React App, and that's something that they don't allow because they're using Babel, which is great. Yep, this is me running into that exact issue. So I think the issue here is that in normal TypeScript, you are allowed to use ambient declarations, which is like sort of TypeScript files without import and export. And then it's just globally available, which is very nice. But Babel doesn't know how to check that, so that's just not allowed in Create React App. So I struggled with that for a bit, then I think I eventually just got this running. I don't know at which point, but yeah, that page that you just saw, that's the extent of me being able to display reviews data. So I think if I skip ahead, we'll be able to see it.
Tequila!
Okay, so at the 2 hour mark, this is me trying to get the active links working in the navigation. I basically finished all the details display stuff, and now I'm just trying to work on cleaning up the rest of the panels on the left. And React, you can see it's much clearer now. That's an XML click. So I just cleaned up the left panel, and I'm trying to make sure that I can navigate back and forth and have the router show up correctly. I think I spent probably an hour on this trying to debug. Basically, Reach Router doesn't do what you would expect with regards to exposing whatever the active link is. So this was a shock to me because it seems like a very basic thing to want. But they just provide a very, very basic prop getter thing, and they put it on the A tag. And there's no way for you to repurpose that to do anything else, which is dumb. So I was stuck on this for probably 1 hour. That sucked.
Shakira, Nacho, Salsa, Sombrero, Gato, Negro, Mojito, Old, El Paso, Madrid, Chihuahua, Adelé, por favor, bailando. Guacamole, jalapeño, Salma Hayek, Ricky Martin, Bacalao, muy bueno, mariachi, gasolina, calamari, muchas gracias, Macarena, mi amigo, leve la vida loca, Antorillo, Banderas, dale. Machete, enchilada, 1, 2, 3, 4, Tony Montana, guacamole, jalapeño, Salma Hayek, Ricky Martin, bacalao, muy bueno, mariachi, gasolina, calamari, muchas gracias, Macarena, mi amigo, leve la vida loca, Antorillo, Banderas, dale.
Okay, almost at the end of the 3 hours, I basically got this showing the course detail page together with reviews. You can click to expand them. Very nice. And obviously, you can navigate the courses as well. And the active panel shows up on the left, which is nice. And that's about it. This is pretty much ready to deploy. am just kind of looking through to see if there's anything I may need to take care of. Here I'm gonna just add a button, because right now I was just relying on the user being able to know that you can click into there to expand, and it's not as nice. So I'm just gonna add a plus minus button here, using hooks, which is very, very nice. So I was gonna go with like expand, close, but then I just decided to use the plus minus button. Anyway, so this is pretty much ready to deploy. I work in Netlify, so I'm gonna show the process of deploying to Netlify. It, you know, that's something I do professionally, so yes, it's very easy for me to figure out, but this site will be hosted on Netlify for the time being until we have other reasons to host it somewhere else, but I'll see you at the end of this video.
Nacho, salsa, sombrero, gato, negro, mojito, old, el paso, Madrid, Chihuahua, Adelé, por favor, bailando. Guacamole, jalapeño, salva Hayek, Ricky Martin, bacalao, muy bueno, mariachi, gasolina, calamari, muchas gracias, Macarena, mi amigo, leve la vida loca, Antorillo, banderas, dale.
Okay, I've checked everything into Git here, and now I'm just going to, and checking into Git means deploying on Netlify. The build process has begun here, I think, and now it's showing up on omscentral.netlify.com. Here's the main page, and then I'm sharing that with the Slack channel where this is being developed. You can click in and see the details. So that took way too long to figure out, but I was just fighting a bunch of tooling that I wasn't that familiar with. So now we have a good foundation to build the rest of the site. And you can see my notes as we go along. I'm going to go and add some music to this, and hopefully this will be a watchable video. I'd love some feedback on whether this video, this kind of video, is helpful to you, whether the audio commentary is helpful to you. If it's sped up, does it mean anything, or is it just fancy? I don't know. Anyway, let me know. Cheers. Bye.